there's a fun new animated film on the way with a stellar Aussie voice cast called Back to the Outback. My family and I were treated to a special screening of the movie in our backyard, and the kids just loved it. On top of that, I also had the pleasure of catching up with one of the stars of the film last week, the brilliant Eric Bana, who plays the voice of zookeeper Chaz Hunt in Back to the Outback.
These animals are deadly. Hear that horrible hiss?
Ugh, gross.
Saw the movie, absolutely loved it. What was it that drew you to this film, and in particular this character, Chaz Hunt?
I really love the concept. I'd worked with Harry before, and Harry and Claire's idea for the story was I thought really wonderful and had a potential for a lot of humour. And then when I read the script and saw drawings in particular of my character Chaz, and saw that moustache and saw those shorts and particularly saw those little chicken legs, I'm like, give me some of that. I know how he should sound.
Yeah, it really is great. I mean, it's kind of, my kids haven't seen it yet. We're going to do like an interactive experience in the garden for it, but I obviously watched it myself. And I'm trying to get my head around it because being from Ireland, I mean, I've never had to deal with snakes. All these little critters, they scare the bejesus out of me, but my kids, they absolutely love them. How important is it to showcase Australia for you and these Australian animals?
Oh, it's such a unique opportunity. You know, I mean, this film, you know, Netflix will make this a pretty massive film internationally in terms of its potential reach. So to be able to focus on these, you know, these Australian insects and reptiles and animals that otherwise, you know, it's normally like the koala bear that gets all the focus and so forth, but to be able to concentrate on these other critters and draw focus on them and make kids more interested in them and find out a little bit more about them. And on top of that, obviously, you know, this incredible Australian cast sounding Australian to an international audience is a really, really unique opportunity. And I'm sure that's why so many of us were wanting to get involved.
They've gone, sir.
We got some deadly creatures to hunt.
How does it, I know you've done a lot of work with the Tasmanian Devils before as well. How is your experience with the Outback, say? I mean, you're from Melbourne, right? You live in Melbourne.
I do, yeah. It's two wheels that gets me out there. I spend a lot of time on two wheels in the bush, and I just feel really comfortable out there. I love it. Obviously, you're a bit more careful when you're camping, you know, than you would be in other parts of the world. But I think that's part of it. And you also realise that if you mind your own business, there really isn't that much to worry about. And they're as scared of you as you are of them, except for the occasional kangaroo I've come across who've been a bit boisterous. But our creatures are, you know, fascinating things, and hopefully this movie will cause little kids to go away and research some of these animals a bit more.
Grab hold of me.
Over there!
Where'd they go?
What I loved as well in the film was Chaz's relationship with Chazzy. Being the father of a son, I mean, I have a son myself. Do you always feel that pressure to live up to those expectations as well?
I love that relationship in the film, and this idea that Chaz is trying to be this kind of archetype, you know, macho Australian animal wrangler who's has no fear, and he's trying to lead the way for his son who idolises him. And in fact, his son may be more brave than the father, as it turns out. And I just love that. But then there's a point in the film, I don't want to give too much away, where we learn that Chaz is super vulnerable and may not be exactly who he purports to be, you know, and all that is in front of his son, which I think is a really beautiful message as well.
Yeah, and a very relatable one as well. Obviously, you may just start in stand-up comedy, and you had like a seamless way, well, supposed seamless ways into these dramatic roles as well. We seem to see you popping up everywhere and just being very comfortable in any role that you play. Do you feel like when it comes to the dramatic roles, having had a comedic background, that it's easy for you to kind of find the humour to switch back out of it then?
Oh, it's a huge advantage, and it comes down to writing. So when you grow up doing stand-up and you're writing your own material, there's a connection to material that you have that's different when you haven't written. And so in terms of breaking down scripts and working out what, you know, when things are working and when things aren't for your character, I do think comedy background is a huge advantage. Being versatile and having the freedom to choose different things is what's really important to me. And so I've been really, you know, really fortunate to be able to do that through my career, and it's something I want to keep doing.
How does preparation for a movie like this, well, obviously it differs a whole lot, but I mean the physicality, say, of when you might have played Hector, you know, stuff like that, because what's the process of this? I mean, you're kind of sitting at home and going, right, that, as opposed to the months in the lead up to getting like that.
Yeah, well, and obviously, you know, the biggest difference is that on the day when you're performing, you're confined to, you know, a corner of a room or a little recording studio, and trying to remind yourself that you can, you know, move around and get some physicality, particularly for Chaz, because a lot of this performance is actually quite physical. So it's about keeping the headphones on and the microphone where it's meant to be and making sure you don't knock yourself out, basically.
It was a Fiji water.
We drank it all, but here.
What is it?
My urine.
Oh. You visited Dublin before, obviously, as well. I read somewhere as well, I mean, I don't want to change it now, I read somewhere that you said you'd never met an Irish person that you didn't like. Hopefully it doesn't start today.
So true. I had a wonderful time there. I worked on a beautiful little film called The Secret Scripture, and we filmed in Dublin and worked with some amazing actors, including Adrian Dunbar. Anyone who's a Line of Duty fan, I almost want to, like, ring him up now. I'm into season 5 and... I'm a bit obsessed, so I had a great time. Yeah, loved Dublin, absolutely loved it.
Oh, great, and obviously Saoirse and Brendan Gleeson as well. I also read you have an affinity towards Mayo as a Gaelic team. The reason I bring that up is because when I moved to Australia first, my first AFL game was St Kilda, and I know they're your team. I saw the game where Fraser Garrick had announced his retirement, the original one. That was my first AFL game. But my best mate is from Mayo. And I used to love when the Aussie teams would come over and play against the Irish team.
Well, I was on a talk show in Ireland one year, and someone was asking me about Australian rules football and my team, St Kilda. And as I was describing the plight of my team, the host of the show said, oh, well, that's kind of like Mayo here. And I'm like, what are you talking about, Mayo? And once I learnt the history, I'm like, well, that's my sister team. That has to be my Gaelic football team. So I'm a proud Mayo fan, and unfortunately, I didn't get it done earlier this year. So fingers crossed for both the Saints and Mayo in 2022.
Nick Riewoldt finally won something. He won MasterChef here on 10, so maybe that's the turning of the tides. Look, it's been an absolute pleasure to speak to you. I really, really appreciate your time, pal. Love.
Thanks, Richard. All the best, mate. Cheers.
I'm going to catch those freaks. I'll raise an army if I have to. And maybe I'm a wild child.
Now, back to you. Back is streaming now on Netflix. Do yourself a favour and watch it.